Hey guys, welcome to the Easy Recaps movie review channel. Today I am going to show you a 2018 war adventure animation movie called Sergeant Stubby, an American Hero. This movie is based on the true story of a dog that was the first world famous dog who worked in the military as a sergeant. In this movie, we are going to see how a dog had joined the US Army and fought against the German forces and achieved the rank of a sergeant. So without any further ado, let's get started. At the beginning of the movie, we see a hungry dog who was looking for food in a city in the United States. While searching for food outside a store, the owner came downstairs and chased him away. He picked up a bone in his mouth and ran away. While running, he collides with a man and his bone gets lost in the crowd. That's when he sees a group of soldiers parading. However, a soldier named Robert caresses him and lets him eat biscuits. The dog feels so happy and started running after the soldiers. Here a background voice narrates that how in 1917 the US Army also got involved in the war where British and France were fighting against Germany. That's why at that time all the children are given the necessary army training mandatorily. However, the scene shifts to the present. We are shown that the battalion of armies has arrived at their camp, and that dog also gets inside, escaping everyone's gaze. Smelling the food, the dog went straight to the kitchen. But the cook saw him and drove him away. While fleeing, he collides with Robert again and starts looking for food from him. Robert says he has nothing to give him, but the dog still pursues him. The sergeant who was training them also noticed this incident, and ordered Robert to give the dog some food after finishing training. After finishing training, Robert takes him to the mess. Although the chef did not want to feed him, now he has no alternative left without giving him food. Robert's friends Olsen and Schroeder tell him that the sergeant is kind to animals, but if the colonel sees him, he must drive him away. However, the next day we see all the soldiers performing their training and that dog also participates in that parade and exercises with the soldiers. The sergeant notices that this dog is not afraid of gunfire at all. He realizes that this dog is different from other dogs. That night Robert named the dog Stubby and gave him training. The next day the colonel comes to meet the soldiers. He notices that the dog, like Robert, is saluting him. He is very impressed to see this, and gives permission to Stubby to stay inside the camp along with all the other soldiers. He quickly became everyone's favorite and was able to understand all the sergeant's orders. Finally, the day came when all the soldiers were being sent to fight. Their division is named Yankee Division. The colonel greets all the soldiers and says that Stubby will stay here and will assist in the training of the next batch. On hearing this, Robert becomes very upset. He tells Stubby that he will be back soon after the war. He gives Stubby a tag and he likes it a lot. Robert then leaves him in the care of the cook and sets out to take part in the battle, saying him the last goodbye. Stubby doesn't like it at all. He missed Robert a lot. He somehow freed himself and started following the troop. He eventually reached the station while chasing after them and got on the train that was taking the troops to the port. Upon arriving at the port, he sees Robert boarding a ship. He hid himself and got on the ship. He looks around for Robert, smelling the things, he finally reaches Robert. Robert is shocked to see Stubby. He had no idea how Stubby got here. That's when Olsen reminds Robert that if anyone sees him here, he'll be in big trouble. So they all started looking for a place to hide Stubby. But suddenly the general of their unit came in front of them. At first glance, the general became a little angry at Stubby. He asks them about Stubby. When he sees Stubby saluting him and handing the lying army stick to him, he became impressed. Seeing this, the general thinks that Stubby can be useful to them. He asks the colonel to declare Stubby the official mascot of the Yankee Division. Schroeder then engraved his name in his tag. However, they eventually reach the battlefield. They see that the condition of the British and French soldiers is pitiful. Suddenly, the German army attacked them. Numerous US and French soldiers were injured. Here, once again, Stubby demonstrates his intelligence by helping the army find the wounded fighters in the rubble, and pull them out of the rubble. Seeing this, everyone in the army started liking Stubby. Meanwhile, Robert is introduced to Gaston, a French soldier who was actually his partner. Soon a good friendship developed between the two of them. Gaston leads them all to the camp. On the way, they see a ruined village. Everything in this village was destroyed by the German army. Upon arrival at the camp, Gaston arranges for them to rest. The next day, the two of them went out for patrolling and hid in one place to keep an eye on the German soldiers. They come to know that German forces are going to attack them with a toxic gas explosion. They rushed to the camp again to report the attack to the others. Here, Stubby sees a German soldier with a gun ready to shoot Robert. Stubby pushes Robert at the right moment and saved his life. They realize that it is impossible for them to get out of here. So Robert shows a mask and tells Stubby to warn the rest of the soldiers. Stubby ran to the camp, took out a mask and threw it into the air. All the soldiers wore their masks as soon as they understood his gesture. Meanwhile, German troops initiate the explosion of the poisonous bomb. Poisonous gases covered the whole sky. There is a village nearby and that village might be affected by this poisonous gas. So Stubby ran to the village and started barking loudly. When they see him barking, they understood that something wrong is going to happen. Just then they see the whole sky filled with toxic gases. They all immediately put on masks and closed doors and windows of their house, locking themselves inside. That's when we see Robert and Gaston arrive in the village. Robert picks up Stubby and takes him to a nearby building. Gaston covers his face with a damp cloth to protect him from these poisonous gases. Soon poisonous gases disappear and the sky becomes clear again. It is seen that all the people of the village are healthy and normal. So many lives have been saved because of Stubby's intelligence. Everyone in the village loves Stubby so much and says that they believe Stubby is a hero. Upon returning to the camp, they learned from the sergeant that one of their soldiers had been wounded in the attack by German forces. However, his position is not going to be traced at all. Upon hearing this, Stubby immediately went out to look for him. He finally reached him escaping the ammunition. That's when Robert and Gaston arrived to help him. Meanwhile, the sergeant uses smoke bombs for their safety. In this way, they rescued the wounded soldiers and returned to the camp. Later, it was learned that their unit would have to be shifted to a new location. Everyone in the battalion is getting ready for this. Before they leave, a village girl presents Stubby with a jacket specially made for him. Gaston also gives him a gas mask especially made for him. They then said goodbye to everyone and left. In the next scene, the colonel informs them that they are now at the forward base, and now they must have to take part in the oncoming battle against the German forces. In the next few scenes, we see some scenes of their battle with the German forces. We see Stubby cleverly made some German soldiers to pursue him and handed them to his team. In the next scene, we see Stubby went on to rescue Olsen from a bomb blast. But he himself got injured. His legs hurt badly. Robert quickly returns to the camp taking him. There, a doctor sends Stubby to the hospital with Olsen, who was also injured. After it, the scene shifts to Robert. He misses Stubby so much that he can't concentrate on the battlefield. Along with this, one day the sergeant ordered Gaston to return to the French army. Robert says Gaston goodbye with a heavy heart. When Robert writes to his sister, we learn that he has not heard from Stubby for weeks, and that he misses him very much. In the next scene, we see that Robert has contracted deadly flu and is seriously ill. The doctor at the camp says that his chances of survival are very low. Meanwhile, we see Stubby in the city hospital. Her legs are still not fully healed, but he sets out alone to find Robert. He was having a hard time walking with a broken leg. At one point he fell to the ground, but he did not give up and kept moving forward. In the next scene, we see that Stubby has finally reached Robert's camp. And seeing him, Robert regains his vitality and recovers very quickly. However, now the soldiers are given a few days off. Getting an opportunity, Robert makes a tour of Paris with Stubby. All the people there respect and love Stubby very much. Robert and Stubby had a great time together. However, the scene again shifted to the battlefield. We see that Stubby, with his intelligence, helped his army to arrest a German spy. The general is very happy with Stubby's achievement, and announces in front of everyone that from today Stubby is being given the rank of a sergeant. Robert was promoted, but it is known that Stubby is now Robert's senior in terms of rank. Gaston also came here to cheer the two of them up. After it, everyone in the Yankee division took pictures together. All the big newspapers cover Stubby's news, and in this way Stubby became a national hero. In the next scene, we see Stubby leading a tank battalion. Robert was much happier for Stubby. This time the US and French armies attacked the German forces to the best of their ability and forced them to retreat. They were all shocked to see the strong bunkers of the German army. But then a soldier came running and told them that the war was coming to an end. The sergeant also confirms the authenticity of this news. He announces that the battle is coming to an end and the ceasefire would be held at 11 a.m. tomorrow. After a long time, tonight they all feel a little relaxed because eventually, the time has come for them to return home. The next day at 9 o'clock in the morning, a fierce battle broke out between the remaining troops, where they tried to push the enemy further back. Here Robert sees Gaston alone advancing on the enemy. After following Gaston, he sees that he is surrounded by two German soldiers. Robert and Stubby arrive immediately to help him. But before anyone could attack, a sudden ceasefire siren sounded and all the soldiers dropped their weapons. Robert saw that it was 11 o'clock, so it was time for them to return home. Then they start looking for their wounded comrades. At one point Stubby finds Olsen's hat there. Schroeder understands that Olsen is no longer alive. Together they pay their last respects to Olsen. They all say goodbye to each other and the Yankee unit leaves for home. Within a few days, their ship arrived at the port, where all the guys are waiting for Stubby and all the rest of the troops. We see that Stubby is treated with the same respect as a sergeant. Here a photographer clicks a photo of him which is still preserved as a memory of this fearless Sergeant Dog. And that's where this beautiful movie comes to an end.